Nah, this is how we go down. Let's get it.
I will find my way. I can go the distance. I'll be there someday. If I can be strong, I know every mile will be worth my while. I would go most anywhere to feel like I belong.
Coming to you live from the Pantheon, it's your boy Jay West here at my co-host Mac East, the only guy I know who could take a lightning bolt to the face.
What up, nerds? It's me, Mac East, and that is true. I have taken a lightning bolt to the face. Today we are talking Disney's Hercules. Nah, it's Blood of Zeus. But for some reason, I couldn't stop thinking about fucking I Can Go the Distance song when I was watching this fucking show.
Oh yeah, I thought the main character was gonna be Hercules a couple of times.
It's just, it's so, like, kind of, it's not exactly alike, but there's, like, I don't know, it's a little similar.
So, before we dive in, quick question. I don't know, are you good with Greek mythology at all?
I'm okay.
How accurate is this show? Because there's things, like, I've never heard of.
Like, the fucking giants?
Yeah.
Nah, that seemed like nonsense to me.
And then there was, I forgot the name, they're not oracles, but they were like these three ghastly figures.
Yeah, the Oneiri?
Yes. Are those correct?
That, you see, we should have looked that up. I'm going to look it up right this second. But I had never heard of them either. Yeah, there's this like weird...
There's a couple of things that I have a lot of questions about. You know what? Let's just, get into it. Obviously, we started watching the new Netflix series, Blood of Zeus. It came out on the 27th of October, and it is one of the top 10 shows on Netflix in the United States currently. And it's a Netflix original.
Yeah, this is kind of, it seems like it's from the same studio that does Castlevania. I don't know.
Oh, I was going to say that because the art style is almost identical.
Even
voice actors to a degree.
Yeah. So, by the way, Oneiris are real.
Okay. I've never heard of them until this.
Yeah, me neither. And they're pretty cool. I actually like the idea of them. Those I kind of figured were real. The giant thing, we'll get into that in a second, I guess.
Yeah.
So the art style is pretty much identical to Castlevania. It seems like this show is kind of playing off Castlevania's success a bit. There's a lot of similarities. It's bloody,
has some of the same bad animations that Castlevania did, I must say.
Big time, yeah.
But yeah, it's definitely the same art style.
Yeah, I don't love it. I don't hate it either. It's passable.
I assume that Netflix must have artists on payroll, and they're using them for their series.
I looked it up when we did Castlevania. I completely forget now, but I think there's like a studio in Texas they use or something. I don't remember. But yeah, they have basically their own animation studio at this point.
Yeah, I figured so much because it looked too much alike. And even though, I don't know, it wasn't exactly subtle. Like, it looks like it's just Castlevania with a different set of clothes.
Well, that's what I mean. I think they wanted people to know that, like, this is the same kind of shit as Castlevania.
Yeah, but it doesn't mean the storyline is going to be as, good. I mean, no, I'm hooked. I'm hooked a little bit now.
So, we watched the first, to let you guys know, we watched the first four episodes. By the end, I like the story a little bit. Nothing is like original in any sort of crazy way. It's all stuff you've kind of seen before, but yeah, I didn't love it. I know this is like super hyped up and maybe we're missing out on the last half of this, but I don't like all the flashbacks and stuff. We watched four episodes, two of them were flashback episodes.
Yeah, I wasn't blown away in the beginning. The first two episodes I was almost done. I was like, Also, the only thing I gotta say is that the story is very, very predictable.
That's what I mean, yeah. Like I knew his brother was gonna be that dude. I totally knew his brother was gonna be that dude.
Yeah, and also I knew Hera was gonna be running things. Like, it just, the way I don't know. Maybe it's because, like, we've all heard the stories and we've seen it reincarnated thousands of times in different ways, but I don't know. So
one thing I like, though, it's they start with this, like, there's all the, like, they talk about how there's all these Greek myths, and then they're like, not all of them have been transcribed, and this is one of those stories. Like, that was a cool little thing in the beginning.
But it's like, because the Titans gave birth to the gods and blah, 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 but it's like the giant, it's like, you know, Zeus and them didn't fight the giants, they fought the Titans.
Yeah, so let's get into that, because, so there's this hierarchy in this show that's established that I've never fucking heard of. It's Titans give birth to giants, which give birth to demons. Which, honestly, I've never heard of demons in Greek mythology at all. I've never heard that term used. But whatever. And the giant thing was weird, because they weren't giants necessarily. They were big, but they weren't, you know, they, like, one of them looked like Medusa, kind of. Like, they had, like...
The fuck is this? Yo, I'm sorry, my cat, he's being a dick right now.
Yeah, it happens. My cat's actually behaving for once.
You know what's crazy? One of them kind of looked like Shiva.
Yeah, they did have, like, gods from other places kind of look to them.
Yeah, I was intrigued by that. But
you know damn also, well they're coming back to life, because their souls are in, like, a fucking box somewhere or something.
There was a couple of interesting things that happened, because throughout this whole thing, you don't see or hear about Hades, and we're four episodes in out of an eight-episode series.
That's an extremely good point.
And we do run into Cerberus in the second episode.
Yeah. Maybe they just couldn't get James Woods. I don't know. But,
that was good. That was good. But
I was surprised. I was, because they even go to hell at some point, and yeah, there's no Hades at all.
Yeah, no one's talked about him, and I would think, you know, he's one of the big three. Like, that's a trump card.
Yeah, I mean, I'm glad he's not the villain here, just because that's.
At first, I thought that was going to be the thing because of the demons, blah blah blah, but then all of a sudden, as they were telling it, I pieced everything together, and I was like, oh, this is what's happening.
Yeah. So I don't know where you want to go first, but there's, like, some fucking hilarious shit to talk about as far as the plot goes.
The cuckold line killed me.
Oh, with the king?
Yeah.
Oh, my God. He, like, opens the baby's eye. For some reason, he knows that the kid's going to have blue eyes if it's Zeus's kid. I guess the dream things told him. But, yeah, so he, like...
Yo, the lady's like, there's two placentas.
I know. That means there's two fathers. Is that science?
Maybe. I don't know. I don't think that's science. I know
that can happen, but is that proof that there? I don't know.
I've never heard of that. I'm not saying that it is not a thing, but I don't think it's a thing. I've never heard of that. Hold on. You know, I gotta look this up. Now I'm gonna look this up.
Yeah. So anyway. So yeah. Haran's mom gives birth to a baby, and the king comes in, and she's like, oh, he's gonna kill my baby, and the king opens the eyes, and it's got brown eyes, and he's like, good, and he, like, hugs it, and then they're like, another baby's coming, and they don't show no labor or nothing, but there's a second baby, and then they say that fucking line, and then he opens that baby's eyes, and it's got blue eyes, and he's like, it's gotta die, and then, like, all this crazy shit happens. Zeus flies in as a bird, and it's all like a dream Haran's having.
Wait, can have individual... Okay, so you can have... If there's, like, twins or two babies or whatever the case... Which is strange. I didn't know you can get impregnated twice.
Yeah, you can get pregnant by two different men, yeah. At the same time.
Yeah, you can. They can have either a shared placenta or two different placentas. So that is a thing.
Right, but two placentas does not mean two different fathers necessarily.
No, because you could have two different placentas with twins.
Right, okay. So that was nonsense. Anyway, so he tries to kill the baby. This is kind of...
We're a mythology and science show now.
Yeah, we're educating you guys. Anyway, so he, like, flies in and he, like, kicks some fucking soldier ass. This is, like, actually in the second episode.
Yeah, Zeus is he's pretty cool. I mean, he's kind of a bitch. And also, I think it's the same voice actor that did Dracula, by the way.
Really?
There was a couple of times where he talked, and I was like, that sounds very, very familiar. But I'm probably wrong. I could be wrong. Who knows? But
Zeus's fight? What's that?
Were you excited to see Zeus fight the guards at all?
Nah, that was whack.
I thought it was pretty tame.
Yeah, you know what's interesting? So we're, you know, and maybe we're getting desensitized as we go on, because like we're doing this era of brutality stuff, and like I'm always on a lookout for like, you know, a nominee for one of these things, and I'm just like, none of this is worth anything. It's just so like, I know people's limbs are getting cut off and shit, but none of it is like,
none of it stands out.
Yeah, yeah, there was nothing crazy.
Kill is the one Cerberus head, I think.
Yeah, when it eats its own neck off and shit, that was kind of cool. Yeah, so I don't know. You know, so let's just fucking jump around. Fucking. So one of my favorite parts of this show is Zeus having to deal with Hera.
Yeah.
Because he's like, yo, he's down there like fucking this broad. And then he like comes home and she's like, where were you? And he's like, I was out with Poseidon. We were just hanging out. Like, leave me alone.
Yeah, he has like seaweed on him and shit.
Yo, that shit was killing me because it's like, yo, I was just hanging out with my buddies. Leave me alone. And it's like, yeah, it's like that shit kind of, at the risk of sounding like too, like, I don't know, social justice warrior-y or something, it's like she got cheated on, so she's a villain, is kind of fucking lame.
Yeah, but also it's like she kind of went overboard, you know what I mean? Like,
well, that's what I mean. It's like, so like she's such a like the crazy woman, you know what I mean? It's like, so like he cheated on her, but we're supposed to be like, fuck,
thousands of years he cheated on her, though. That's the thing. It's not the first time.
Well, in actual mythology, he would like turn into goats and go fuck goats and shit. Like he
would also like hang out and like fuck people.
Yeah, yeah, he was not above fucking people, man. I mean, that is how Hercules was born and a bunch of others. Yeah, so, like, she's, like, bitching at him, and he's like, leave me alone, woman. And it's just, like, so domestic for gods. It's crazy.
Yeah, but the one line that was funny, the human lady that he's banging, I forgot her name, he's like, she goes, you fear her more than you love me. And I was like, damn, son.
I know. He's like, you know, scared of his wife. It's like, it's almost like a fucking sitcom or something. It's so ridiculous. Like,
Zeus is supposed to be like the almighty. And there's this one scene where, with the baby scene, where Zeus fights those guards. It's Zeus.
Yeah.
Like, he should have, like, one, no one even, like, trembled in fear of the fact that God is in front of you.
Word, for real.
Nonetheless, like, he could have smited them, like, instantly. What the fuck?
That's the thing. I didn't need limbs falling off. I needed, like, smoldering, electrocuted dudes. You know what I mean? Like, that would have been way cooler.
Yeah, or just, like, him being, like, showing up and they all, like, fucking bowing. Like, no, we can't fucking fight Zeus. Like, they had no fear. Like, just Zeus.
Yeah. Yeah.
Beat his ass, boys.
The other thing that, and I don't think this is mythology, there's a point where he's like fighting with Hera and she's like, I was like the queen of the skies
or something, the queen of the heavens. Yeah.
Like, it was implied that somehow she was the thunder, like the lightning god.
Hera was the agriculture and stuff.
Yeah, like I don't know where the fuck that line came from or how her powers got transferred to him after he fucked her. I don't know, that was like nonsense.
Well, I mean, I would say this is loosely based on Greek mythology at this point, because there's a lot of weird shit that's happening.
I think they wanted to make her like a proper protagonist for, I mean, antagonist for him. So they wanted her to be like on his level. You know what I mean?
I guess, but it's like, I don't know. It's fucking Hera. Like, the only Hera that's ever scared me was from like Kevin Sorbo's Hercules. So just the eyes and the peacock things. Like,
I've never actually seen it.
But actually, I remember in God of War, Hera gets her neck broken, like, instantly.
Yeah, so you've played I haven't played God of War. Is there any overlap for that, or?
Ish, because Kratos ends up being, like, Zeus's half-son. That's why he's such a beast. But,
fuck's sake.
Hera's, like, talking shit, and Kratos is like, yo, watch your mouth. And he literally just grabs her by the neck and snaps her neck like a person.
All right, well, that's crazy. Yeah, so that's the other
thing. Video game where you murder the fucking entire mythology.
So that's the other thing. Haran doesn't have very much, like, he's powerful. Like, so before we know that he's the son of Zeus, he, like, gets his ass whipped by a demon and they throw, like, a fucking pillar on him. And I was like, how is this dude not fucked up? And then also I was like, why is this dude jacked? He's fucking poor as shit. But No, then you realize, oh, he's the son of Zeus. That makes a lot of sense, I guess. So yeah. He has, like, good durability and, like, he's definitely stronger than the average person, but he doesn't seem overly strong. He's not like a Hercules or something.
No, and that's the thing, though. It's like he's not special enough. But he's the son of fucking Zeus.
I gotta say, this dude is extremely generic as a protagonist. Like, I have zero interest in him.
And this woman, like, she was a queen. Like, he has nothing. Like, he's nothing special at all. Run of the mill. Only thing cool is his eyes.
Yeah, he's got kind of a generic look. He has a cool-ass sword for, like, a second, and then he throws a tantrum and throws it.
Okay, so real fast. Looking up Hera right now. Her Roman name was Juno. The wife of Zeus and queen of the ancient Greek gods represented the ideal woman and was goddess of marriage and the family. However, she was perhaps the most famous for her jealous and vengeful nature, principally aimed at the lovers of her husband and their illegitimate offspring.
Well, there you go. Goddesses be crazy, bro. Goddesses be crazy.
Wild. What is her power? Superhuman strength. That's all she has. Okay, Hera possesses the typical ability of speed, durability, reflexes. Oh, she could teleport and do interdimensional travel. And she's also an exorcist. Okay, whatever. And she can ride Hephaestus's chariots. Whatever.
So one thing I like about the show, the dynamic between her and Zeus, I like how, like, she's corrupting the one brother and he's, like, got the other brother. Like, yeah. I like that little thing.
But it's just crazy because the whole thing was planned by Hera from the start, and it's like, you know that.
Yeah. I also, like, Zeus being the guy. Go ahead.
Oh, I thought they were going to do the whole typical bad guy bullshit where, like, she doesn't be, like, revealed to the bad guy, like, you are the one that murdered your mother.
Yeah, I'm glad that that happened, but it also, like, was so uninteresting to me. You know what I mean? Like, because then they do this thing. They show a flashback of it. Like, we didn't just watch that shit. Like, oh, my God. The flashbacks are too much.
Eat of my flesh thing, though. Like, the whole giant thing is very, very peculiar.
I don't like it. I wish they would have just been, like, eat the titan. You know, I wish they would have just had titans and been like, oh, they're eating titan flesh or something.
Like, the second that they did the fight with Haran and the bad guy, I knew that that was his brother. Like, immediately. Yeah. I was like, huh, that's probably his brother that we thought died.
Well, I knew. I mean, come on. They didn't introduce the brother just for him to be dead. There was no fucking way. Like, that's why that reveal was so corny. It was like I think the flashbacks kind of hurt this show. Like, I think it would be better to, like, reveal this stuff slowly. Instead of just being like, here's what happens, you know, like in a whole episode. It also kills the momentum a little bit because we're just starting to learn who this dude is as, like, an adult. And then we go back and have to watch his, like, fucking growing up. You know what I mean?
But I am hooked on it because I do want to see how it plays out at the end of the last four seasons. I mean, episodes. I would like to see how it plays out. But I'm not interested in this show nearly as much as I was everything else.
You know what? Who knows? Maybe it'll build up to something dope in the last few episodes. Because
they got to be making season two.
There's a decent amount of action for, like, the first. You know, like, it doesn't. It'll probably really pick up towards the end. I have to imagine. But I also don't like the demons. Like, their look isn't all that cool either.
No, and now they all have, like, that stone arm. The one thing that I don't like about the battles is the battles are pretty lackluster, and then something kind of big will happen, but it'll be, you won't, for instance, there's this one scene where they're fighting and he knocks over some oil bottles or some oil vase, yeah, and then shoots it with an arrow, and you don't really, it doesn't affect anything, but, like, we just see it in the background.
Yeah, it's the same thing where he knocks down that rock that he sets up as a trap. I want to see those, like, if we're going to go violent, let's see them dudes burn to death. Let's see them dudes get crushed by that fucking boulder. You know what I mean? Like,
they kind of just cop out at the end. And like, no, we're not going to show you the reveal.
Yeah, I don't know.
Cost of animation, but I feel like it's just sloppy and it's anticlimactic because it's like, oh, shit, he's going to burn these motherfuckers alive. And then you see the flame go up and then that was it.
Yeah. How whack was the scene, too, where the mother gets killed? And then,
dude, that was lame.
And how long, yo, how long did she get taken to fucking hell? Oh my God. There was like not even any talking. It was like he takes her body out. Zeus looks at her. And then he just like, I think it's Apollo, right?
Yeah. For some reason.
I don't know why it's Apollo, but it's Apollo. He takes her to hell. And then they just like look at hell for like fucking way too long without like anything happening. And then he blows the fucking horn. It's just like so, like it was like,
they were trying to set the dramatic overtone, like.
But if the animation was more
80s, but Karen looked really weird.
Yeah, if the animation was better, like, not like I said, I don't hate the animation. I just think it's kind of, it's okay. If the animation was fantastic, then you could do these like sweeping looking like shots. You know what I mean? But the fact that it's like kind of generic looking animation.
Yeah, but the way they were trying to build hell and the way it was playing off on screen, it was like it wasn't working.
Nah, and I mean it looked cool, but at the same time, like it was way too long.
Nah, it's okay. Like I wasn't like, well, all right. For instance, when in Wallachia, when the Castlevania castle drops and then all the windows open. And you see demons pouring out. That's a whoa moment. Like,
well, Castlevania is really good at like creating shots, like with the moon and all this stuff. Like, there's a lot of really. But cool.
That's what I'm saying, though. If it's the same animators and you're trying to show someplace such as Hell or the River of Styx, where it's like there's this big impact moment where you're supposed to take it in and be like, "Whoa,
yeah,
this is scary or this is intense." Have it be intense. You know what I mean? Yeah. Like, it was very underwhelming.
Yeah, it was kind of a swing and a miss for me, too. So, and then they have the Amazon chick. What do you think of her?
It's cool. I got a lot of Wonder Woman vibes from it. Like,
I don't know. Did they say right away? It took me a while to realize she was an Amazon. I didn't know that.
The only reason I know about the Amazon thing is because I read up on it as I was watching the episode. I was like, oh, that's what that is. I thought maybe she was like a Spartan or something.
Yeah, that's what I thought. And then there's a point where they actually call her. Like, I think the demons are looking for her, and they're like talking about the Amazon.
Yeah, they're like, we're looking for the Amazonas or whatever they said.
Yeah, so I didn't pick that up right away. I thought she was just like a regular soldier from some kingdom or something. I don't know. She's cool, I guess. I like her.
But remember, she's not real.
Oh, well, is that true, though?
That was Hera.
No, I know, but I think that she is real, but that was like a... She knew that he was looking for her, so she, like, used that image to trap him.
I guess. I mean, I don't know.
I guess your interpretation, based on what we've watched, could be true. I don't know.
Because I feel like she could have done that to get all of his attention, to leave him vulnerable, to reveal the fucking insane truth.
The only thing I...
Which is why I go through all that, just show up to him in a dream.
The only reason I think that Amazon chick is real is because of the map. Which seems like an important thing.
Yeah, you're right. Hera would have already been able to read that.
Yeah, I don't know what's with that map. We didn't get to that. The map is cool, I guess. Whatever. I don't know. It's a Maltese Falcon kind of situation. It's an important object that people need to be chasing around.
I guess. I mean, no one else knows how to read it but the demons.
Yeah, it was weird. Tucci, like, fucking, she has the map.
Supported Citrus on it.
Yeah, why? And how did she know that would work? Like, what the fuck was that?
Yeah, she sliced an orange pretty cool and then, like, squeezed it on the page and then put the page in front of the file. I guess because I have no idea how she knew to do that, man.
So, yeah. So, I think, yeah, it's weird. We've talked about the show a bunch already. We've not talked about her on it that much at all. It shows you how generic that dude is.
He doesn't do anything.
Yeah, like, I didn't even feel bad for him when he finds out his dad. Like, they didn't let that moment breathe at all. Like, they didn't build up to it.
Nope.
They're like, oh, your dad's Zeus in the fucking, like, first episode. And there's no, like, I wasn't like, oh, shit, or like, oh, that's cool. I was like, kind of knew that, whatever.
Yeah, I don't know. The show does a lot of swing and misses, but I do want to see how it plays out.
I'm not going to not finish it. And you know what? If we get enough, all right, this is what we'll do. If we get enough views on this shit or enough downloads, we'll cover the second half.
That's fair.
We could, I mean, obviously we could watch it without having to record it, but yeah. So if you guys show up to check out this episode, we'll do the second half.
Yeah. If you want to hear this, let us know or whatever, but
yeah, you could also let us know if we hear enough people asking for it, we'll definitely cover the second half. I don't know.
Honestly, this whole thing kind of took a different a different road than our normal episodes, because I feel like our normal like pattern is out the window and we're just kind of talking about it like it's some bullshit.
Yeah, well, that's the thing. That's why I'm like, yo, we'll cover it, but we're kind of shitting on it. And if you guys are like feeling this, sorry to shit on your cereal.
I mean, but I'm not, because
it's all right. It's nothing special. It's nothing special at all.
The way it was hyped up, though, I'm not gonna lie. Like I was in the hype, man. I was like, yo, I texted you about this. I was like, dude, they're making an anime out of mythology. It's gonna be amazing.
Yeah, I've actually seen a few people throw it up there and be like, this is great. And I'm like, I guess. I don't know. Like, what is the standard these days? I don't know.
You know, that's a very good question.
You know what? And my girlfriend says it's a conspiracy, but she's starting to believe it. I really think Netflix is like, they're like the biggest geniuses at convincing people their shit is good. But like, once it's out of the hype machine, people just forget the shit's so forgettable. You know what I mean? Like,
yep.
They do it all the time. Like, remember Bird Box? I thought Bird Box was the biggest piece of shit. And everybody was fucking memeing the shit out of it. I think Netflix was putting these memes out like crazy. And it's just, and everybody's using these memes, people, and this fucking movie sucked. And nobody gives a fuck about that movie. You know what I mean? Like, now it's like, you know, once it's in the hype machine, people are like, oh, Netflix, this. And then once it's out, people fucking forget it.
Yeah.
So that's how I kind of feel about Netflix. And I think they're very good at manufacturing hype for their shows.
Well, I mean, you have to be.
And more power to them, you know? And I mean, they're good in a viral way. Like, it's not commercials. It's memes and, you know, Twitter and Instagram and all this stuff. And they get people talking about their shit through word of mouth.
Wow. I mean, what do you expect?
All right. My Netflix rant is over. I will say they do put out good shit. You know, Castlevania.
They put out a lot of shit, dude. And we have an episode coming up about another Netflix original. I feel like season 3 is just going to be like Netflix originals.
So, yeah, I don't know, but it yeah.
All right, what's your final verdict? Would you recommend this?
No.
All right, fair enough. I would recommend it only if you're into Greek mythology and stuff like that, and you would check it out. If I was going to send you in the direction of anime, I would not send you down this path.
Yeah, I think there's some cool stuff. I like the dynamic of, like, each Hera and Zeus having their own, like, person there. Zeus is, like, the guy in the chair for Haran, and, like, Hera's, like, fucking manipulating this other brother who had, like, a shit life. He sucked bear milk when he was a baby. And
that was pretty cool.
We didn't talk about that. Yeah, he's like
raised. We didn't talk about a lot of shit that happened, but yeah, that dude was raised by bears.
Yeah, he's like raised by bears, and then he's like got this Mowgli look to him. And then he gets his eye cut out. I don't know. Whatever. Hera sends the bears to him.
When he kills the uncle or his cousins, that was pretty neat.
Let me ask you though, what the fuck? Like, I'm like, okay, he nursed bears. He nursed on a mother bear. So, you know, that's, like, kind of a cool thing. Like, oh, maybe he's, like, a beast because he, like, drank bear milk as a baby. But then it's, like, none of that matters because he eats a demon chunk. He eats a giant chunk, and now he's that. You know what I mean? Like, none of his early childhood even fucking mattered as far as, like, training and, like, all, you know?
I mean, but he didn't exactly train either. He was just, like, a dude.
But he was, like, badass. He was, like, he took out a few soldiers, man.
No, he did. He did.
As, like, a small child.
Yeah, I don't know how that happened or how he knew to do any of that, but this is, you know, a cartoon.
Yeah, it's fine. I'm not, like, mad about any of that. I'm just like...
No, I mean, now that you're putting it in my head now, I'm kind of annoyed.
Like, raised by bears is, like, a cool thing, but then none of that matters because he's a demon. Like...
Yeah, the whole, like, bear thing. But even then, like, who would he... He ain't gonna fight a grizzly bear to train to fucking learn how to throw spears.
Who taught him how to shoot a bow and arrow? I don't know. Like, the servant broad was there, but I doubt she could shoot a bow.
Yeah, she was loyal to the end, son.
Yeah, also that scene where the uncle throws the baby off the cliff. Oh, my God.
That was so bad.
That scene went on for way too long. Like, he's just, like,
just kind of casually drops him.
Yeah, the one thing I did like, the cape goes up a couple times, and then the last time it goes up and comes down, he, like, had already dropped the kid. Like, that was kind of cool. But... before that it took so long to get there, and we all knew it was going to happen, that it was like, eh. You know, like, they're not building any tension because we know what's happening in every scene.
Anyway. Yeah, it just, the overall feel was, it just, you knew what was going to happen. You knew what was going to happen. Oh, my God, you knew what was happening. I think it just comes down to poor execution.
How about the, okay, so here's one thing about the animation before we quit. The triple threat match between Ares, Hermes, and Apollo.
Okay, I was fucking with my guy Ares hard.
Like, yo, that happened for no reason, but it was fun to watch.
Yeah, but, like, there were people in the stands.
I know, yeah, gods were watching this triple threat. I don't know why it was a triple threat. Yo, Hermes actually showed some shit. He was, like, doing some flash shit.
Yeah, but then he got caught by the neck. That was dope.
Yo, I like when Apollo comes with the sword and Ares, like matrixes that shit, but it scrapes against his helmet.
Yeah, no,
right, that was across his face. That was cool.
That was probably the coolest fight, and it's because they're the gods, you know what I mean?
So that's what makes me think this show has some potential, because that action, and as far as action goes, because the plot is meh, but that action scene was pretty good. So maybe we'll get some crazy shit later.
I mean, I would assume. Also, like I said, we have 4 episodes left. I mean,
and yeah, and that's a lot for these Netflix cartoons. Like, the last Castlevania season was like fucking 7 episodes or something.
Yeah.
So 4 is a lot for Netflix cartoon.
Well.
All right. Now, you want to do ratings for this or just?
All right. Yeah. Screw it. Let's do it.
All right.
Out of what? 5?
Yeah, 5.
I'll give it a 2 out of 5.
2. I'm going to go 1.5.
Yeah, I mean, only because, like, I like a couple things that they do, and I'm kind of a sucker for Greek mythology stuff, so.
Yeah, when I was younger, Greek mythology shit got my dick so hard, and it's not as much as it used to.
Yeah, it just, the plot is, like, I'm not really interested. I was able to figure everything out, like, instantly, and, you know, once again, the animation is really lacking. So I can't really go that hard for this. But I do like it, so it gets a 2.
Yeah, and I guess, well, if you guys hit us up, if you guys want us to do it, we'll watch and see if Haran can go the distance.
I doubt it. That's probably where Season 2 is going to come in.
Yeah, let's see if he can go from zero to hero.
Zero to hero, you piece of shit.
I'm dropping all of it. I'm dropping all of it. Anyway, so you guys can check us out at We Get Dubbed on Twitter. Also on Instagram. You can check out our YouTube channel. We've been uploading shit lately. Hit us with all your obscenities. We want the comment section just full of fucking gross chaos. It's hilarious, and that's what we want, so do it.
There you go. Motivational speech of the day.
Yeah, because you guys haven't been doing it, so fuck you guys. Now come tell us to go fuck ourselves. Yeah, and then, yeah, we got some shit going. We got the WeGetDub.com.
Yep, where you can check out all of Mac's fancy reviews and check out the Era of Brutality stats and see how everything ranks up.
Yeah, so this is, like, not that, right? I mean...
I thought it might have been a cool participant for the Era of Brutality one because it brings, a modern flow to everything, but this is not brutal at all.
Yeah, so I did a kill count just before we end. 72 kills, which is not bad for 4 fucking episodes.
I mean, it's not bad at all, but also it's fucking chaos and massive amounts of explosions. So.
Yeah, and, obviously those are loosely counted because sometimes you just see, like, a sea of people and I have to count that. But,
yeah, do you think this should be in the Era of Brutality? I don't know.
It kind of sucks. It's too modern. I'm not against modern stuff being in it, but this is like, I don't think it hits brutality enough.
One got like ripped in half.
Not really. You know what was cool when he finds the woman in the fountain and he like picks her up and then her guts are like out.
Yeah,
that was cool. That was really cool. That's when I was like, oh, this show might be for the Era of Brutality, but then it wasn't.
Yeah, not enough disembowelments.
Anyway, guys. So yeah. We forgot to talk about the stickers. I would have liked to put that in earlier.
I mean, we could save it for the next episode because we're doing a double header, folks.
Well, we're recording doubleheader-wise, yeah. You guys will hear them as normal episodes, but you know what? Let's talk about them, and maybe I can fucking splice it into the beginning. I'm not going to do that. Anyway, so we got some cool fucking Pokemon stickers. I made Pokemon cards out of us and made stickers out of that.
Pretty awesome.
And yeah, they're cool. They're up for grabs. If you guys want them, DM us with your address. The only thing, we'll send them to you. The only thing we ask is that you send us pictures of where you stuck them. Unless it's where the sun don't shine.
Hashtag we get dub with it, please.
maybe, even if it's where the sun don't shine. Show us all your pictures.
I mean, I think you just involuntarily asked for dick pics somewhere.
No, butt pics. I'm asking, if you stick this to your butt, I need to see that.
I'm about to stick it to my butt. Shit.
So, yeah, think of the advertising if we get some butt pics with these fucking things stuck to them.
Put them on your girlfriend's butts. No, don't do that. I mean, you could, but yeah.
No, this is getting out of hand. It was a dumb joke. We're not asking to see a naked girlfriend.
I am.
I mean, look, if that's honestly where you want to stick the sticker and then send it to us, send us that picture. We're not gonna not take the picture. anyway, guys. So
I'm glad I got to turn this ending into chaos.
Yeah, no, this is good. This is good. Yeah. So this is another stumbling
botched outro. Look at that.
We were so close. We were so close. Anyway, goodbye. I'm gonna hit that outro, guys. This is Jay West and Mac East. I'm hitting that
later.
Outro. Later.